Hey friends of the earth, this is Waylon Lewis wishing you a happy, happy, happy Martin Luther King Jr. Day. And by happy, I mean it is one of the heavier, more profound, more truly joyful holidays that we get to celebrate as Americans, as human beings in this whole world. So if you're just tuning in, I want to talk a little bit about sort of the revisionism that has been happening around Martin Luther King Jr. by a bunch of hipster, progressive, liberal types on Instagram and Twitter who have nothing better to do. So over the last few years, particularly last year, it became cool among kind of hipster Instagram types to say that Martin Luther King Jr. was actually totally fine with aggression and kind of changed his mind later in his life. And while some of that may be true, there are countless quotes, countless quotes, countless quotes by him, countless speeches. We have these on Elephant, his powerful speeches that love is not a passive thing. Love is not sitting back and being kind of moderate and being okay with injustice and being okay with violence. Love is not a passive thing. Love is an active thing. Love is caring. Love is being willing to put your bodily safety on the line for justice, for peace, for love. But love is also not aggression. He never endorsed aggression. There's a difference between anger. You know that phrase where we say, if you're not angry right now, you're not paying attention. Heck yes. Hell yes. Yes. So we got to be angry, but we can't let that anger lead to aggression. Or, and there's countless quotes, please click the links in the sidebar on Facebook. If you're on Instagram, you can go to elephantjournal.com and search nonviolence Martin Luther King. There are countless quotes that are so powerful about, you know, we don't go, is similar to Michelle Obama's quote, we don't let their aggression, we don't let their bullets, we don't let their bombs make us do the same thing. We don't let them bring us low in that way. So we have to remember, love is not, oh, totally, dude, it's all good. Love is not, it's all good. Love is caring. Love is activism. Love is subscribing to real journalism. Love is getting involved in marches. Love is voting and not wasting your vote. Love is eating food that's real. You know, and not supporting these big corporations who are killing farmers and killing our wildlife and killing our lands, supporting real local farmers. That's something we should all of whatever political stripe be able to agree on. Love is, you know, supporting science, not just conspiracy theories. Love is an active, caring thing. So in Buddhism, we say it's the middle way. There's an extreme where you think love is just the way, and love is all good, and love, but you don't actually show up and you don't really help out. That's what Martin Luther King Jr. was criticizing about the white moderate in that famous speech late in his life. He said, I'm more bothered by the white moderate who says nice stuff and sits back and but doesn't do anything than by the Ku Klux Klansman, because at least that's, they're sort of blatantly honest, even though that was cowardly and awful. So let's stop pretending that aggression or anger that becomes aggression is okay, and that Martin Luther King Jr. supported that. But at the same time, let's stop supporting the sort of moderate, like it's all good kind of love. Love is active, love is caring. I wrote some other stuff on this. There's hopefully that link in the sidebar, but and I compiled one of his amazing quotes, and maybe I'll just read one of them, and then we'll stop. This will be a short little talk. This is by the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. True nonviolent resistance is not unrealistic submission to evil power. It is rather a courageous confrontation of evil by the power of love, in the faith that is better, that it is better to be the recipient of violence than the inflictor of it, since the latter only multiplies the existence of violence and bitterness in the universe. When we fall into aggression, we only multiply the existence of violence and bitterness in the universe. While the former, being the recipient of violence, may develop a sense of shame in the opponent and thereby bring about a transformation and change of heart. So before we get all Instagram righteous Twitter righteous, social media hipster progressive righteous. Let's remember that people like Thich Nhat Hanh, Martin Luther King Jr., Gandhi, these are people who put their safety and thousands and millions of others who are not famous have put their safety and their hearts on the line for nonviolence. The nonviolent tradition, whether it's Henry David Thoreau or Gandhi, or Thich Nhat Hanh or Martin Luther King, is a lineage that we all need to feel like we belong to and we need to support. And remember, nonviolence is not passive weakness. It's not accepting of the violence, but it's trying to actually end the cycle of violence. As we say in Buddhism, aggression begets aggression. Allen Ginsberg, a very famous peace activist and poet and Buddhist, said that he had a lot more experience in activism than most of us. And he said, aggression begets aggression. So let's just remember on this day that there is no excuse for aggression. We can be angry. If we're not angry, we're not paying attention. And that anger can lead us to protest, to vote, to serve others. As Martin Luther King Jr. said, you know, that's the question of life. How are we serving others? As Eleanor Roosevelt said, service leads to genuine joy. So I send you all big love on Martin Luther King Jr. Day. He should be all of our idols. And also a final point, he wasn't perfect. You know, we shouldn't idolize people and think they're perfect and then have to pull them down and tear them down. And he was a human being, which doesn't let us off the hook. If he was human and imperfect and yet so heroic and showed up, then we can too. All right. Someone's asking what's up with the Christmas tree. I'm Buddhist, so I don't particularly think of it as a Christmas tree, but I do love the winter time. And it was a local tree that had to be felled anyway. And it's a bit of a Charlie Brown Christmas tree. And I got it very late. I got it on December 24th, Christmas Eve, and it will stay up in as long as it's happy because I love having it in this house. And it's hanging with lots of local crafts. I love to support local artists. And it just is beautiful and it smells wonderful. All right, huge thanks to all of you. And if you'd like to support independent media, you can subscribe. You'll see 90% fewer ads and you'll get to read unlimited elephant articles, including all the articles on Martin Luther King Jr. and Gandhi. If not, you can read for free anytime, a couple articles a day. Big love. And when I hang up, you can subscribe by clicking the subscribe link.